हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू कर्मा एजुकेशन। दिस इज़ ए चैनल फॉर यूजीसी नेट एजुकेशन सब्जेक्ट पेपर टू ओनली। लेट स्टार्ट आवर न्यू सेशन। प्रैक्टिस विद मी 5 क्वेश्चंस इन 10 मिनट्स, सेट नंबर 4। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, मैच द फॉलोइंग टू सेट्स। सेट 1 प्रोवाइड्स द फॉर्म ऑफ कॉजेशन, व्हाइल सेट 2 गिव्स द नेम ऑफ मेटाफिजिकल एंटिटीज एज पोस्टुलेटेड बाय सांख्य फिलोसॉफी। सेट 1, फॉर्म ऑफ कॉजेशन। ऑप्शन ए कॉज ओनली, ऑप्शन बी इफेक्ट ओनली, ऑप्शन सी बोथ कॉज एंड इफेक्ट, एंड ऑप्शन डी नाइदर कॉज नॉर इफेक्ट। एंड इन सेट 2 मेटाफिजिकल एंटिटीज, ऑप्शन 1 पुरुषा, ऑप्शन 2 धनवंतरस, ऑप्शन 3 सेंसरी एंड मोटर ऑर्गन्स, ऑप्शन 4 ईश्वर, एंड ऑप्शन 5 प्रकृति। It is a common question and it is also very important for your upcoming UGC NET exam. Probably you all know the answer of the question, but still I want to make it clear in little bit detail. According to Sankhya philosophy, the universe was born from the union of Prakriti and Purusha. Both Prakriti and Purusha are eternal. Eternal means everlasting or never ending. And indestructible means unbreakable. Purusha is neither cause nor effect. But why? Because it is eternal without cause and immutable. Immutable means that is fixed or unchangeable. And it is metaphysical consciousness, means the consciousness which is beyond physical world. That's why Purusha is neither cause nor effect. So option 1 of set 2, that is Purusha, will be matched with option D of set 1, that is neither cause nor effect, right? Next, Prakriti. Prakriti refers to unintelligent, unconscious and root of all beings. And it has 3 gunas, Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. Through the interplay of these 3 gunas, Prakriti binds the Purusha. That's why Prakriti is cause of creation. So, option 5 of set 2, that is Prakriti, will be matched with option A of set 1, that is cause only. Now, I will discuss which metaphysical entities are known as effect only and both cause and effect. In the process of evolution of universe, when Purusha or pure consciousness comes into the contact with Prakriti, then the first product is Mahat or Buddhi, which is evolved. Second product is Ahankara, and Ahankara consists of 3 gunas of Prakriti, that is Sattvic, Rajasic and Tamasic. From Sattvic Ahankara, mind, 5 Gyanendriyas, 5 Karmendriyas are evolved. These are only effect in the evolution process. So, from Sattvic Ahankara, 5 Gyanendriyas and 5 Karmendriyas are evolved. These are known as only effect, right? From the Tamasic Ahankara, 5 subtle elements and 5 gross elements evolved. Among these 5 subtle elements are both cause and effect in the evolution process. And Rajasic Ahankara energize both Sattvic and Tamasic Ahankara. So, option B of set 1, that is effect only, will be matched with option 3 of set 2, that is sensory and motor organs, means 5 Gyanendriyas and 5 Karmendriyas. And option C of set 1, that is both cause and effect, will be matched with option 2 of set 2, that is Tanmantras. Tanmantras means 5 subtle elements. These are sound, touch, form, taste and smell. So finally, from the given code, the correct option will be option 4. I have given the link of Sankhya philosophy in the description box, where I already discussed these in more detail. You can watch the video. Question number 2. The Panchakosha theory of education was elaborated by Sri Aurobindo, Swami Vivekanand, Patanjali, Mahatma Gandhi. The question is asked about panchakosha, means five seats. Seats means container. Five seats of our body, that is annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, vigyanmaya kosha, and anandamaya kosha. This panchakosha theory of education was elaborated by whom? The answer will be option C, that is Patanjali. Patanjali was a sage in ancient India, author of Mahabhashya, compiler of Yoga Sutra. Yoga Sutras is a text on yoga theory and practice. And he was notable scholar of Sankhya school of Hindu philosophy. You can watch the video of Yoga Philosophy where I discussed about Panchakosha in detail. I have given the link in description box. Question number 3. The reality is in the constant flux, hence knowledge is essentially relative in nature. Who among the following educators will favor this proposition? Immanuel Kant, John Dewey, David Hume, Leibniz. Immanuel Kant believes in idealism. According to idealism, ultimate reality is idea or mind, and reality is not relative. Option 2, that is John Dewey. John Dewey believes in pragmatism. According to pragmatism, there is no ultimate reality. Reality is determined by sense experience, and it is not one but many. As they believe, reality is not fixed, it is constantly changing. Hence, knowledge is essentially relative in nature. According to pragmatism, ultimate knowledge is the knowledge which works. Knowledge is like a tool or instrument to experience reality. Option 3, David Hume. David Hume believes in naturalism. According to naturalism, matter or nature is only reality. And option 4, Leibniz. He believes in idealism. So, the correct option will be option 2, that is John Dewey. He will favor the proposition that is the reality is in the constant flux, hence knowledge is essentially relative in nature, as he believes in pragmatism. Question number 4. Which of the following statements finds support from an existentialist teacher? Option 1, education is value-centric. Option 2, education is instinctive. Option 3, education is contextual. Option 4, education is perennial. So the question is, from the given options, you have to select only one statement which is supported by existentialism. Option A, education is value-centric. According to existentialism, there is no predetermined fixed values. Values should be freely chosen by men. Knowledge will be imparted as per human nature. From these concepts of values and education, we can say that the statement that is given in the option 1, education is value-centric, it will not be supported by an existentialist teacher. Option 2, education is instinctive. Instinctive means inborn or innate, or which is natural. As existentialists have given priority to self-knowledge, then we can say that education is instinctive. Option 3, education is contextual, means education depends on circumstances. And option 4, education is perennial. It means education is unending or everlasting. So finally, after explaining all the options, we can say that option 2, that is education is instinctive, this statement will be supported by an existentialist teacher as they have given priority to self-knowledge. Question number 5, the last question of the set 4. Which of the following schools of philosophy regards education as a means for social growth and economic production? Option 1, idealism. Option 2, realism. Option 3, naturalism. And option 4, Marxism. The answer will be option 4, Marxism. Marxism school of philosophy regards education as a means for social growth and economic production. I have given link of the video on Marxism. You can watch the video to know more in detail. We will be back with set 5. Practice with me 5 questions in 10 minutes very soon. Keep watching Karma Education and comment me which portion should I cover by MCQ for your upcoming NET exam. Thank you.